My name is Diane, and I work the Pikesville Branch Baltimore County Public Library. Thank you for joining me for our steam-powered program. Today's project will be building a marble roller coaster using things from around your home. Let's get started. First, we're going to need some thin paper plates. We'll also need some cardboard tubes for support. If you don't have any cardboard tubes around your house, you could take paper like this cardstock or any other thick paper and roll it together to create tubes and just tape it together. You can also use a cardboard box that you cut into pieces and again tape together. This will make a wonderful support. You will also need something for the base of your roller coaster. In my case, we're going to be using some cardstock paper that I taped together. You could use a cardboard box or anything else that you might have around your home. You're also going to need some scissors for doing the cutting, and you'll need some tape for putting it together. I'm using masking tape, but any tape really will do. And last but not least, you'll need a marble. So let's start our project. We're going to start with the paper plates, and we're going to cut out the center of the paper plate. So start at the edge, and just cut around very quickly. When you're doing this, you probably want to start with maybe three paper plates. That should give you enough for a good size roller coaster. And then we're going to cut the pieces, paper plate into a few pieces. And now we're all ready to start putting it together. So I'm going to take my cardstock to create my base. Don't worry about making it as really big to start with. You can add pieces as you're going. I'm then going to add my cardboard tube as my first support. I like to build my roller coaster from the tallest point to the lowest point, so I'm going to start with my tallest tube. Again, make it as high as you want, make it as low as you want. Totally up to you. I'm just securing that with a few pieces of paper. A few pieces of tape, I'm sorry. Next, we're going to add our paper plate pieces. First, before you add one of the pieces, you want to curve it in half much as possible. What this will do will be to create a gully here. This will allow you to create walls along so your marble is less likely to roll off the side as you're going down the roller coaster. I just like to curve the bottom. It makes it a little easier to attach to the paper, to the cardboard tube. We're just adding a few pieces of tape here. And as I'm doing this, you'll notice I'm not making this pretty. I'm an engineer, not an artist. So now we take another piece of paper plate. Again, remember to fold it in half. And then we're going to attach it to the end of our previous paper plate. Now remember, as you're doing this, that you don't want to be careful here about putting too much tape, because you want your marble to be able to flow down. Okay, and as you notice, as I'm doing this, it's knocking my support off here. Not surprising. So what will we do? Let's add another support. And we're going to tape this one into place. I'm going to tape the top. Again, being careful not to put too much on the top of it to block the marble. And then we'll tape the bottom as well. And that's pretty much all you have to do for this project. You'll just keep adding additional pieces of paper plate so that it makes the slope of the roller coaster go down towards your table. You'll add supports as needed and extra base pieces as needed. Let me give you two tips for when you're doing this. Remember, as you're going, to fold your cardboard, the paper plate, because it will again provide a railing for your marble and it will keep it from flying off the track. The second tip to remember is the steeper your track is, the faster your marble will go. That may sound like a really cool thing, however, if it goes really fast, it's more likely to fly off your track. So you want to make sure that you're balancing speed with keeping it under control. So when you're done, you may end up with something like this. This track here is one I built earlier, and you can try running your marble down. So let's grab a marble and see how it goes. And it fell off. So what do you do? That's not a failure. Something to learn from. So what are we going to do? You may want to bend your track a little bit more Maybe in some cases you want to add additional supports. Although these are different options, again, you're going to practice this over and over again. Don't worry if it doesn't work on your first try. It didn't for me. It didn't work on the second or third one either. Again, just keep trying and eventually you'll get it to work. And it will go just like that. So thank you very much for joining me today. If you want other projects like this, please see our website, bcpl.info. One of my favorite places is the research databases, and you'll see our Science Reference Center has hundreds of science projects for you to do. Again, thank you for joining me.